Dear students, a very warm welcome in the series of lectures of microbiology. Today we are going to discuss on the topic MVIC. It is very important topic related to microbiological examinations of water quality. With this test or with this examination, we can distinguish fecal and non-fecal coliforms. MVIC. The name MVIC reactions was coined by Parr. Parr took the first letters of each of four biochemical tests. Each of the letters in MVIC stands for one of these tests. I is for indol, M is for methyl red, V is for Voges Proske, and C is for citrate. MVIC is an acronym that stands for four different tests, that is indole test, methyl red test, Voges Proske test and citrate test. First of all, we will discuss indole test. Indole test is used to determine the ability of an organism to split amino acid tryptophan to form the compound indole. Tryptophan is used in the tryptone broth when sample, water sample or bacterial sample is added. Tryptone or tryptophan is hydrolyzed by tryptophanase to produce three possible end products, and indole is one of that. When indole is produced, its production is detected by COX reagent, which contains 4 para-dimethyl aminobenzaldehyde. It reacts with indole to produce red colored compound, and in this picture we can see here that red color is produced, indicating the production of indole by microorganism present in water sample. Here is the reaction given how tryptophan is converted into indole by enzyme tryptophanase. Next reaction or test is methyl red test. Methyl red test determines whether the microbe performs mixed acids fermentation when supplied glucose. Types and proportion of fermentation products produced by anaerobic fermentation of glucose is one of the key taxonomic characteristics which help to differentiate various genera of enteric bacteria. Mixed acid fermentation is one of the two broad patterns, 2,3-butanediol fermentation being another pattern. In mixed acid fermentation, three acids, acetic acid, lactic acid and succinic acid, are formed in significant amounts. The mixed acid pathway gives 4 molecules of acidic products, mainly lactic acid and acetic acid, 1 molecule of neutral fermentation product, that is ethanol, 1 molecule of carbon dioxide and 1 molecule of hydrogen per molecule of glucose fermented. These large amounts of acid result significant decrease in pH of the medium below 4.4. This is visualized by using pH indicator. Here, methyl red reaction is given where glucose is being fermented to produce mixed acids and carbon dioxide is produced as a byproduct. In methyl red test, glucose peptone broth is taken. Here methyl red is used as an indicator. Glucose peptone broth is maintained at pH 6. When water sample or bacterial sample is added, the pH of the glucose peptone broth is reduced to 4.4 when mixed acid fermentation takes place. Methyl red indicator, which is yellow above pH 5.1 and red at pH 4.4, indicates the presence of fermentating microorganism in water sample. The pH at which methyl red detects acid is considerably low than the pH for other indicators used in bacteriological culture media. Thus, to produce a color change, the test organism must produce large quantities of acid from carbohydrate substrate being used. Here in this picture, we can see that glucose peptone broth at pH 6 is still yellow in color, whereas when the pH of the medium is reduced or lowered to 4 or below 4, the indicator color turns red from yellow, and this shows positive reaction for the presence of fermentating microorganism in the sample. Next test is Voges-Proskauer test. Voges-Proskauer is a double eponym named after two microbiologists working at the beginning of 20th century. This reaction is based on the ability of microorganism to produce acetyl methyl carbinol or acetone in glucose peptone medium. In this reaction, we can see that glucose is being converted into acetone by microorganisms. This acetone is converted into diacetyl when KOH is added. KOH is VP1, that is Voges-Proskauer reagent 1. Diacetyl, when treated with VP2 reagent, that is alpha naphthol, gives a pink to red or crimson red color product, indicating the presence of coliforms. In this pathway, we can see that in glucose peptone broth, when water sample is added or bacterial sample is added, acetone is produced. Production of acetone and diacetyl is indicated when VP1 and VP2 is added, producing a crimson red color or pink to red color. This is positive reaction for Voges-Proskauer test. Here in this picture, we can see that glucose peptone broth still remained yellow, indicating that acetone and diacetyl is not produced. While in the second picture here, we can see that Voges-Proskauer reaction is positive, that is pink to red or crimson red color is produced. Next test is citrate test. Citrate utilization test. Citrate utilization test is commonly employed as a part of group of tests that distinguish between members of Enterobacteriaceae family based on their metabolic byproducts. Citrate utilization can be used to distinguish between coliforms, such as Klebsiella aerogenes, which occur naturally in soil and in aquatic environments. The fecal coliforms such as Escherichia coli, whose presence would be indicative of fecal contamination. Citrate utilization test is used to determine the ability of bacteria to utilize sodium citrate as its only carbon source, and inorganic ammonium hydrogen phosphate is the sole fixed nitrogen source. Here, the medium used is Siemens sodium citrate agar. When water sample or bacterial sample is streaked on the surface of solid agar medium, the bromothymol blue color changes from green to blue. This is the indicator of positive test for citrate utilization. Differential identification of fecal and non-fecal coliforms. Herein, these four tests differentially identifies fecal and non-fecal coliforms. Indole test is positive for fecal coliforms. That is, all the fecal coliforms gives positive test, a positive reaction in indole test. That is, they produce red color. Methyl red test are positive for fecal coliforms. Voges-Proskauer test and citrate utilization tests are positive for non-fecal coliforms. In this way, by this test, we can identify or distinguish coliforms into two groups, that is fecal coliforms. If the reaction indole test and methyl red test are positive, then the group of coliforms can be categorized in fecal coliforms. If indole test and methyl red test are negative, but VP test and citrate test are positive, then the group of coliforms can be categorized in non-fecal coliforms. In this way, IMVIC test is used for the differential identification of fecal and non-fecal coliforms. These are the references. Thank you.